John Soane was one of the great architects of the late 18th and early 19th century who had a profound effect on architects around the world, particularly in America. Here we are in a square, a typical London square, surrounded by stock London brick, rather modest. And on the front here is a frontispiece he designed for his own house, making it one of the most extraordinary houses for an architect in the history of Western architecture. This modesty here, and this is incredible advertisement out front. John Soane spoke about a building as a self-portrait, particularly this one. So what kind of a character does it reveal? What sort of a self-portrait is it? It's really complex, clearly, full of dark spaces and light. Is it really a house, or is it more like a temple to his life? John Soane became a kind of can opener for Americans to study history because he was a serious architect who loved and learned from history.
I was looking at a classical theater at Harvard, and the dean came by and took the right-hand side of the book. He said, "You won't need that here." I was stunned for weeks.
This was a great breakthrough for me to thumb my nose at my mentor, Mies van der Rohe, and to say things should be warmer and toastier and sexier than they are in modern trebuchated, square-beamed architecture.
Soane walked into this ballroom early one May morning, and he would have been dazzled by this astonishingly strong Sicilian sunlight. It's the first time he's seen a house where the builder has built a private house without any restraint at all on his architectural imagination. This is pure architectural fantasy. It breaks every single rule of taste and design that Soane has studied at the Academy. All design when Soane was in his early 60s have become icons of modern architecture.
History is always important. It's always valid. It's always a basis for learning.
Architectural history was taboo.